This is Buckskin Gulch. Located just outside of Kanab, Utah, it is considered one of the longest continuous salt canyons in the world, with approximately 20 miles of hiking if you want to complete the entire canyon. But you don't have to hike all that far to experience views like this. We completed a short 6 mile round trip day hike, and that was more than enough to take in the towering 100-foot walls, narrow corridors, and beautiful red sandstone colors. Welcome back, everyone. Today we are in Kanab, Utah, and we are going to check out Buckskin Gulch. This is the longest and deepest slot canyon in the Southwest United States and possibly the entire United States. To start this hike, we are going to park at the Wire Pass Trailhead. This is actually the same trailhead that you can park at to start the hike for the wave, but for this hike, you don't need to do an advanced lottery. For Buckskin Gulch, you have to go online where you have to pay $6 per person to have a day pass to park and hike in this area.
When you go online to pay for your day pass at recreation.gov, they will send you a link, an email to print out your pass. However, you can also stop at the visitor center in the town of Kanab and pick up one of these day use permit cards to write the information on a place in your window in case you don't have a place that you can print your permit. This hike is through a slot canyon, so wet, rainy weather can make these very dangerous. So another reason we stopped at the visitor center yesterday was to check the weather. It's a very low chance of flash floods, but they also give you a website when you pay for your day pass to go online and check weather there. Okay, we've entered the first area of the Slot Canyon. This first part is Wire Pass Slot Canyon area. So you go through here first before you get to the actual Buckskin Gulch Canyon. This is the summer of trails with ladders and sketchy climbs.
We're gonna see if Kari can catch you. Ready?
That hand-eye coordination.
Spark, it's a little thin.
Many sections of this trail are less than 10 feet wide, and at times can feel like the canyon is closing in on you. You can also see debris that has wedged itself in the canyon, an indication of how high the water can be during a flash flood. As you continue on, the canyon does open up and you are greeted with petroglyphs left behind from a time long ago, estimated to be over 700 years old.
There's a bunch.
I wish I knew what they meant.
I'm pretty sure that's a deer or antelope.
No, Mike wasn't mean.
They saw one.
Is it?
I don't know.
Oh, there's probably like a meaning behind it. Like that's how they communicated with other people.
That's pretty cool, seeing the petroglyphs. Who knows exactly how old? I'm sure a few thousand years, but really cool to know that this has been around for that long and people have been coming down here. So far it's been the single slot canyon, and then you come to an impasse. We come to a section right here where you can go left or right, but we are following the all trails and I'm using the Onyx backcountry app, and both of those say to go right here. The trail we're doing is approximately 5 or 6 miles.
Yeah.
This goes obviously much longer. I believe it's like
12.
I would say like 12 or 13 miles one way.
You
You can do overnight backpacks. Obviously we're doing a day trip, which honestly, to see the beauty of the canyon, I mean that's pretty much all you need. I'm sure it'd be beautiful to go further, but just the day trip has been beautiful so far.
got a long way to go. These walls are massive, like hundreds of feet tall. This is such a cool hike. And you really don't even need to go that far into it if you don't want to get the cool experience of being inside the canyon.
One thing I like to say is this is actually really beautiful and pretty peaceful for how fairly easy of a drive it was to get here. We've done Lower Antelope Canyon, which is a beautiful slot canyon, which is close by in Page, Arizona. However, it's very touristy and busy, and while you may get better reds and colors of the sandstone, this is so nice because it's really feels like it's just us. And the walls here are bigger. So I think it's worth it.
I think we say this all the time, but this canyon just keeps getting better and better the further you go. The walls are growing, Tyler says, but they're getting more like wavy and closer together and narrow and taller. But this part we just got to, we just turned a corner, probably my favorite part so far. This is just crazy.
The canyon was mesmerizing, and we loved the color changes as the sun would reflect off the walls, creating unique shadows and variation throughout the hike.
For some reason, I feel like I'm in the movie Aladdin.
Okay, so through like the last mile, GPS doesn't work because the canyon's so narrow. So we just have the trail pulled up. Fortunately, Kari's Strava still tracked her mileage roughly. We kind of kept guesstimating based on our maps where we were at, and we got to about the 3 mile mark. And all of a sudden, the canyon opened up and we got enough GPS to tell us this is about the end of the All Trails hike, which is about 3 miles one way. Obviously, the canyon keeps going. You can go so long, but we're gonna go to that big opening because we're just curious, but you can turn around whenever. It's just really hard to turn around because it is just beautiful every turn. So we're gonna go another about 100 yards and then probably head back.
I was hoping to find these horses because there's still horse poop on this trail. So here's kind of your end of trail marker. You'll come to this. Not only does the canyon open up, but right when you turn left, there's this huge arch opening in the canyon wall, and then it opens up much bigger straight ahead. So
okay, everybody. Hopefully you enjoyed seeing Buckskin Gulch, and as we hike back, enjoy some photos that we've taken as we've been here.
I wanted to take a moment to say thank you for everyone that has watched our videos, and we hope you enjoyed this one. Please consider liking and or subscribing if you want to stick around and see more adventures. And we hope you get a chance to experience some of the beautiful places that are out there. See you next time.